Good evening, everyone who's here in person, and then also to those of you, I know that I have family members and maybe Mark does, who are watching this, the live stream. So I'd like to say a few words. A couple of years ago, my dear friend and colleague, Mark Clinton, and I began discussing the idea of performing the all five of the Beethoven sonatas for cello and piano. And then last fall, we played three of the sonatas, the first, fourth, and fifth. And I had planned last year to say a few words about the pieces, but was getting over a cold and had no voice. I could play, but I could not speak. Thankfully tonight, I have a speaking voice, but don't worry, I'll be brief. You believe me? Okay. So the five sonatas were written between 1796 and 1815, and they represent Beethoven's early, middle, and late periods, like many of his other works, like the symphonies, the piano concertos, the string quartets, and so on, and the violin sonatas and so on. This evening's program will begin with the third sonata, the A major, opus 69, the most famous of the cellos, the cello sonatas, which Beethoven originally titled the Grand Sonata for Pianoforte and Violoncello. Now, supposedly, it was more common up to this point to give the sonatas the title of using the piano first and then the cello, because so many of the sonatas up to that point were for cello obbligato, piano with cello obbligato. But first I want to say a little bit about the Opus 5 cello sonatas. The first one we played last fall. They were written in 1796, the same year Beethoven began composing the eyeglass duet for viola and cello. Usually it's only violists and cellists that know that piece. And a year after his first piano concerto, and a couple of years before his first set of string quartets. He finished composing the two Opus 5 sonatas while on tour in Berlin, which was, at the time, the capital of Prussia. He dedicated the Opus 5 sonatas to King Frederick the Great's nephew, Prince Friedrich Wilhelm II, who had become king by the time the sonatas were written, and was one of Beethoven's most devoted patrons. The court orchestra at the time employed two of the greatest cellists in Europe, the Dupour brothers, Jean-Louis and Jean-Pierre. Friedrich, the king, was an amateur cellist who studied with Jean-Pierre, the oldest of the Dupour brothers, who was principal cellist of the court orchestra. The first two sonatas were premiered the same year they were composed, in 1796. One would assume that Friedrich's teacher, Jean-Pierre, would have played the premiere. However, it is believed that his younger brother, Jean-Louis, received the honor of doing so with none other than Beethoven himself playing the piano, the forte piano at the time. The cello sonatas at the time were either, like I said before, written for keyboard for cello with keyboard accompaniment, like Vivaldi, Corelli, Tartini, Boccherini, a lot of Italian composers, and they would write solo sonatas for the cello with piano accompaniment. And on the flip side of that, there were a lot of sonatas that were written for piano with cello obbligato, okay? So, and that was similar kind of writing in the piano trios of Mozart and Haydn, where the cello basically doubled the bass line of the piano. Both of the Opus 5 sonatas represent a turning point in the cello sonata repertoire, where the cello isn't treated strictly as an obbligato or accompanying instrument, but begins to have more of the melodic material and a more independent voice. Of course, no matter how you slice it, the piano is always going to have more notes. Yeah. Beethoven composed the Opus 69 sonata that we'll start with in 1808 while also working on the Fifth and Sixth Symphonies. The sonata was dedicated to his close friend and supporter, Baron Gleichenstein, who was also an amateur cellist. There were lots of amateur cellists at the time, evidently, and they were all royalty. However, the sonata was premiered by cellist Nikolaus Kraft and pianist Dorothea von Ertwan, who and Kraft studied in Berlin with Jean-Louis Duport, and Ertwang was a piano student of Beethoven. In fact, it is believed that many of Beethoven's works would have vanished if not for Ertwang's performances. She was considered one of the greatest interpreters of his music and was held in high esteem by Beethoven. The A major sonata is considered the first real duo sonata for this instrumentation, and its first movement is a textbook example of sonata form for those of you who have had form and analysis in music theory. In closing, Mark and I have had an incredible time collaborating on these masterpieces and can't wait to share them with you. So without further ado, here's the A major. And after the A major sonata, we'll take a brief pause and continue with the G minor. Also, before I forget, we would like to dedicate this evening's performance to the memory of a former colleague who was here when we first started teaching here, Joan Reist, who was on the piano faculty, piano pedagogy, and taught keyboard skills, and she passed away last Saturday. So, Joni, this is in honor of you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
one thing about this next sonata, because I didn't realize this till I had read some up on it a little bit. And the G minor, actually I think both the F major and G minor, the two opus five sonatas, but maybe it was just this one, that there was a famous Italian bassist named Dragonetti who played this on the bass with Beethoven playing the piano. And then it was at that point that Beethoven realized, wow, the bass can do a lot more than I thought it could. And so then he started giving the bass, in his symphonies, the bass is played the same thing that the cello's played. So you have Dragonetti to thank for that, the bassist out here.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.